A lot of you have been working very hard to get to this point, including our team, but I know most folks in here who are presenting and speaking. Thank you for your effort, and we are here at the RIC Forum in Dallas, Texas, so thank you for joining us.
This is the future technology that's going to enable the innovations in our networks that are going to lead to new markets, new applications, new experiences for ourselves and for the consumers around the world.
One of the key things we've done in that sub-project is to identify where the industry needs to focus. And so what we've done is we've highlighted what are the key use cases.
So this is what I think AI can help you provide. It can help you explain the root cause of the observed network behavior so that you can start taking some actions.
We are opening up the layer 2 and creating few levers that can be controlled through the E2 interface so that you can have much more granular energy saving than just not switching off a cell or a cable.
This is the time when we've got to do research and dive deep into that technology, because the promise of RIC is absolutely huge.
Most everything we need is somewhere in the spec. It's just not being built yet. You know, on the commercial side, it's not necessary, but it's definitely necessary on the DoD side.
Based on this idea of programmability, and by tapping into the raw data sources that the vendors expose, we can now build new or modify existing service models on the fly.
So you'll see a live demo from midnight in Singapore.
Now we are sitting in a classroom. So this classroom is designed to enable a lot of new XR-based learning. So maybe our cameraman can show one of the XR applications that is being supported by a 5G network.
When we are running critical infrastructure in the cloud, we need to think about the security requirements for critical infrastructure in the cloud. This is not a mom and pop flower shop that is just another tenant deploying in the cloud.
So you will see kind of like an oscillating behavior in the Grafana, because we wanted to kind of like show that the slicing decision is being performed in real time in something that you can actually see.
If I don't react, the user experience is going to be impacted. So how do I achieve that balance? That's where the KPI module comes in, to give a feedback to the third module, which is the module that predicts, or rather decides, what's the policy to be issued with the right thresholds.
Our academic colleagues now can take their innovative solutions and they can move very quickly into production environment, because they're being developed within this standard, well-defined framework.
This combined value eventually reaches a threshold of interest from the RApp to be able to do a centralized energy savings action to turn off the capacity cell for energy saving purposes.
What I'm hearing from my clients is that Open RAN, and particularly RIC, surprisingly, is very useful in that, in the creation or the adaptation of the connectivity.
Some of the energy savings features which are available in this platform, we've been able to integrate. Some we'll be able to show. Cell switch on or a carrier switch on, switch off. RF reconfiguration and micro sleep.
Once you get to a common platform, you've got open interfaces, open standard by which to develop these applications, it'll become much easier for new entrants into the space.
It's been very close to our heart to have a RIC platform which is developer ready, which is open, and that is also very pragmatic in the way you can, yes, comply to standard, but also make sure that you can align with the reality of the RAN elements and what they support in terms of controls and data.
Governments are one of the biggest buyers of basically any products in any economy, and connectivity is no different. So whether that's through defense applications or whether it's through, you know, connectivity in hospitals or university campuses or public transport or whatever it might be.
If you just provide APIs or an R1 interface or X1 interface, nothing happens. That's not enough. You've got to provide the documentation, the tutorial, the simulations, the test environments, hold conferences, have forums, etc. So I think another part of industrializing is doing all that for the RIC.
Wow. I mean, wow. What did we just see? We saw 10 live demonstrations of real networks happening, one right after the other. And there's not that many times where you're going to come to a meeting and you're going to see something like that. That was impressive.